Well, hello everybody and welcome to another exciting episode of JCPW. I am here with my co-host and my fellow member of the management chair, Mr. Jason Titus. How are we feeling today?
We're doing great. We have finally crowned our first ever vacant champion, soon to be announced what that championship is tonight. I think we have a pretty good night ahead of us.
We definitely do. Actually, just like a little spoiler, Tom Doyle will be coming out to explain what this title is going to be. So we will get to see. He's gonna show the new title. I think he probably had it already made. I think he was that confident in winning the whole thing. But he's had the title already made. I think we are gonna hear from Tom Doyle now. We're gonna head over to the ring announcer to let you know who he is. And there he is, Tom. Look at that title. Oh, he's holding it in his hand there.
Gotta say, that's quite a distinct design right there. Not quite as, you know, I'm not gonna say it's not quite as mid-cardy, but I definitely think that is an impressive looking title. That he seems to be carrying that pretty confidently as he walks down to the ring, I must say. Tom Doyle must feel pretty proud of this championship right now.
Definitely, it does look good, so hopefully we'll get a closer look as he goes into the ring and shows us what it's all about, and he'll explain the rules of that title as well, and we will give you a quick brief overload of what those belts, those things are, but we've got a little zoom in on that title. Let's have a look. Any clues? Is he strong style?
Strong style indeed. Seems to be kind of like a kind of MMA kind of like mission based thing.
Well, here we go. We're going to hand over to Tom to see what he's got to say. Tom Doyle, mic is yours. Looking confident as ever. He's got the mic. So here we go. He's going to tell us what this title is all about. Here we go. Over to you, Tom. There it is, the Strong Style title.
The title will always be in his favor, he says. Okay.
Let's see the breakdown of the rules, what he's going to put into these. Oh, inside a cage. I had a feeling that's the kind of thing we'd see.
Either tap him out or knock him out. Oh dear, strong MMA representation in that belt.
The thing is though, I gotta be honest, I was expecting something unique. You know, I've seen MMA titles. Just as I say that, there's the twist. Whoa. Did he select the opponents?
Oh, I guess it's kind of that crowd involvement, the watchers' involvement in this. Interesting choice from Tom.
Oh, wow, that is a big one.
Any company? Well, hold on, who signed off on this?
It's his title. He can do what he wants with it. That is the thing. It's, you know, we've got nothing to say. We can't do. So he's got to come see me and. Well, there we have it, ladies. Short, sweet, the Strong Style title. Jason.
I'm kind of dumbfounded right now. I was not expecting that. He said not only did he lay out the challenge to any guy in JCPW, but in any company ever. Oh my goodness, that is really something right there.
That is definitely something there. And the fact is, we got a lot of links with a lot of other companies, so there's going to be some people interested in that one. But we've got to move on with our opening match. And Jason, this is going to be exciting. It is a three-way women's match. No, it's not. Is it? Yes. It is a three-way. We've got three debuts. Well, two debuts and a returner.
Really? Seems as though this is an interesting little thing for us right now.
This is Sara, Psycho Sara, I think it's Sara Psycho. One way or the other, we'll get the confirmation now as it comes up onto the screen. So we've got Psycho Sara, Sara Psycho. I guess it's I've never heard, I've never seen. Interesting look though.
Yeah, definitely interesting look. She seems to have a spiked elbow pad. That could probably come in as very dangerous in the match. Probably want to avoid that.
Definitely one of those. I think, well, you're taking that from, you know, a well-known female superstar who used to use that spiked pad to her advantage. Maybe she's getting that form, you never know.
Mm-hmm.
There's our first entrance. Psycho Sara, if I remember my notes right, it is Psycho Sara, and here's our second. There's the second debut. This is what I like about these debut matches. The good thing about multi-man matches here in JCPW, they are all elimination matches. Again, something unique that we've always brought you in JCPW.
Mm-hmm. What's this? Coming out with a cape. Can't get an exact look at their figure right now. Can't even see who they exactly are.
Oh, big explosion. I wasn't expecting that then. This is, I think, if I check my notes, this is Akari Star, or known as AK for short.
Hey, I like her swagger right now. Definitely kind of coming in with a bang, as you can see earlier. She seems to be pretty confident as she makes her way down to the ring. That cape kind of flowing behind her. This definitely, I'm liking what I'm seeing so far.
There's Akari Star. Definitely, again, the thing is, these are superstars we don't really know a lot. Yeah, we signed them and watched them, but don't really know a lot about them. So that is the sweetness. That is the best thing about these kind of matches, these debut matches. So we don't even know if more explosions. You know, I'm so happy to set up in the box. I'm probably going to get my eyebrows off.
Definitely. Not to mention, not only are we safe in the box from explosions, we're safe from the possible carnage that can be brought near us in these types of matches, especially with these people we don't know. You know, they can bring out pretty much anything, but, you know, that makes it all the more fun.
It definitely is, but this is the returning superstar I'm talking about. Now, obviously, Jason, as you know, we've got a lot of partnerships with a lot of different companies around core wrestling, and one of those is GPW, or Grand Prix Wrestling. And who we are seeing here making her return is a superstar unique in her look. You'll definitely see when she makes her way out to the ring. Unique in her look and very impressive. She's a former two-time or three-time GPW Women's Champion, won multiple champions, multiple championships across the board. So definitely a star to look forward to. We'll get to see a look. And I want your initial reaction. Don't just see the face, Jason. I want to know the initial reaction.
Oh, you'll definitely get it. It seems like the snake that's being brought. Whoa! Okay. This is unusual from what I would normally expect.
Well, if you want to try something, this is Bad Amy. This is also known as Bad Amy, and again, a superstar who's been here in GPW once or twice, but never really committed-ish. But she is very. She goes to a lot of places, and again, explosions galore tonight. How much did we spend on pyro tonight?
Jesus Christ, the pyros are going crazy. A lot of these people making a for sure entrance, and seems like Bad Amy. She definitely, again, that swagger, a lot of swagger that we've been seeing from a lot of the women here. They've been showing out. Let's see if she can, like, keep up with the likes of AK, or if they can keep up with the likes of Bad Amy.
It definitely is. It'll be an interesting match between Psycho Sara, Bad Amy also making her return to JCPW, and Akari Star, or AK, actually. No! My budget is going to be through the roof.
Hey man, it's partially your company, so I can't tell you how to spend or whatnot, but you know.
Well, the thing is, I've gone through all the accounts. So, well, I'm gonna have to check my accountant to see who's paying for this pyro. But the thing is, it's your debut. You're making your return. You wanna make a statement.
Most definitely, you do. And what better statement by beating two brand new women, showcasing why you are the top dog in JP. Oh, and the new women, okay, going after each other. Psycho Sara going after AK. Oh, and I need the kick to the back.
Big knee to the back of the head there. Both all three ladies have taken a shot at each other. You're gonna need a lot more to keep Bad Amy down. And the thing is, this what Bad Amy has it up on the shoulders. Oh, bro, to sleep into the German.
What a maneuver by Bad Amy. I can definitely see why she's a big deal in GPW if she's going out like swinging like this, picking her up. And here comes AK and a suplex! Oh, Falcon Arrow, my bad. And Bad Amy is going after everybody. No one is safe. And oh, puts down the legs, but hey, Psycho Sara pushes her off. Oh, and a big calf kick right there.
And there's the experience of Bad Amy rolling to the outside. In the ring, we see AK there with a Koji clutch. Old school there.
Sara quick to get off. Fortunately for her, I think the spikes on the elbow weren't exactly able to connect with her face quite, but definitely got hit in the face getting away. And oh, what's this? Oh, some type of inverted DDT.
Reverse DDT now, and now it sees Sara against Bad Amy. Bad Amy is experienced. Look at this. Caught the back of her neck on the bottom turnbuckle.
But Sarah's back up. Oh, what the detonation kick. Oh, but oh, again, that elbow hitting her against the face. Oh, she hits into Amy, but it gets hit in the back. And another. Oh, but this time the spiked elbow crushing her. Oh, but Bad Amy picks her up. And oh, a detonation kick of her own.
Bit of a receipt there. You want him? Oh, super kick party there from AK. Beautiful kick, just catching Bad Amy. Oh, we see that beautiful running knee strike. We've seen Mercedes and JC Wolfe use that.
And but AK doesn't seem to keep AK down. AK with a Hurricane Rana. Sara is getting up on the outside. Oh, and roll up! One! Oh, but no, not quite enough. Bad Amy is going to have to do a little bit better than that. And once again, she's up. Oh, and bro to sleep and into a German suplex. AK has been eaten those alive. And what's this? And a super... Oh,
Emma,
I guess that was like
frozen
a...
Emma frozen there. Almost like a snowplow style move there. Psycho Sara, nice combination of kicks. Oh, nice there. There's that oriental background she does have.
Keeping down AK right there. That's a good and smart move. And what's this? Oh, dropping her down on the knee. And she's just shouting at her right now. Whoa. Oh! Did you see that?
Straight punch to the face. Took off AK's face with that. The beautiful, almost like a code breaker style move there. It goes in place.
AK is not stopping it, not trying to get the advantage of anyone right there. But oh, Psycho Sara saying, "No one help me." Then hey, I'm not gonna help you stay in this match. Oh,
Bad Amy breaking that up to show why. Oh, dragon cutter into the dragon. Oh, I love this dragon clutch. This beautiful move, really cranking back, especially the angle. But Sara sees the damage, that sees the danger she's in. Again,
just yelling at her. Whoa, but AK, is this an alliance we're seeing?
We could see something here. I'll see from seeing the match so far, you please say Akari is the faster person with a beautiful spinning knee strike. Is that gonna be enough? Take out the veteran. Oh, what a match, Jason.
This has been a great showing from all these women right now. Seems as though every time we think one person's gonna have the pure advantage, another person just pops up. That's the thing about here in JCPW. You never know who's going to win until the end, until the ending of the match.
Definitely is a nice little fisherman's driver there from AK, but bad Amy. Able to get another one of those strikes there. That looks like Psycho Sara wants to get in on the action.
Entering back into the ring. Meanwhile, AK just pounding against the face of Bad Amy. And Sara, there she is. And, Russian leg sweep on the concrete floor. But, AK was getting back up.
But she got kicked straight back down there by Bad Amy. Like, who's your money on Survivor? I mean, this is a great match. All three ladies have been really impressive.
Yeah, very much. I can't even say my money's on anyone for certain. Like, all these women, these kicks, those shoot-type kicks right there, wearing down Bad Amy. But as I was saying, I don't think anyone for sure I can say is my favorite. All these women have definitely been impressing me. I'm not too familiar with Psycho Sara and, AK, but they're definitely giving something for me to like with that bulldog right there. AK and Psycho Sara squaring off, but seems like Sara tosses AK to the outside.
Great matches, and that's how Bad Amy rolled to the outside, maybe to get a break, but AK is able to just reverse that up there. And we're going to see it from AK, strike to the back. Bad Amy just slowly recovering on the outside. What the hell is that?
Some type of on track with the leg, like a leg wrap DDT, and that took out Psycho Sara. She's right now standing toe to toe with the woman of GPW. Seems like that might have just taken her out. One, two.
Bad Amy picks up that tactical. Great tactics there from Bad Amy. Saw the big move, and then comes in out of nowhere with the eight. With the bad DDT. Impressive.
A lot of back and forth competition right there from all of these women. I don't think anyone here tagged anything to get take that. I don't think anyone here didn't have anything to bring to the table. I think everybody here shined a lot.
Three ladies who have definitely got a future here in JCW. And that's a good thing. We are building our women's division as we build our men's division. And there we see Bad Amy. Congratulations to Bad Amy taking the victory back to GPW. But Jason, you know what's coming after the match.
Oh, man.
We are going to take a really short commercial break, everybody. So we'll be right back after this. But for now, get those drinks in. So go get yourself your refreshments, and we'll be back for you with the next part of the show right after this commercial break. We'll see you all soon. JCPW, what an opening match we had there. Three ladies making their debut.
And definitely showcasing why they all should call this place their home in JCPW, putting nearly everything on the line winning that match.
Definitely did, and it's good to see. But we are now going to go into our next match, and we are going to see a member of BK4 in action. after that, we're going to see the former women's champion's boyfriend. We're going to see Blake Steele, also known as V12, going into this one. Now, I know he's not, you've not seen Blake Steele before.
I believe I have seen Blake Steele before in my Heartbreaker tournament. However, I didn't get to see as much of him as I wanted to, as, you know, unfortunate world champion and his wife ended up beating V12. But, you know, I feel like, from what I've seen from him, he definitely has a lot to bring to the table. Very powerful guy, very strong in the ring. You know, he probably could bring it in a really good match here.
Yes, he does. He has got a tough task ahead of him because he is taking on the enforcer of VK4. Now, we've seen Barnett. I don't know if he's seen Barnett yet, but we are going to see Mason Wolfe. Now, this guy is an absolute spectacle. Big, muscular, just wait to see. I'm thinking so. He's one of those guys that you'd expect, great wrestler, great powerhouse, but so agile as well. Think of a Dominic Dijakovic style superstar.
Comes Mason Wolfe. Now, if memory serves me correctly, I believe I've seen this guy before, and he went against Ace Andreas. An unfortunate, I think, loss for him, but I think that loss stuck with him, and he's gonna want to prove something tonight against the boyfriend of the former women's champion.
Yeah, he's gonna want to prove something, and he is being trailed by JC Wolfe, JC in the background, they make his way down to the ring as well. I mean, he had an impressive show, but Ace just managed to pull out the victory. And this is a guy that doesn't like to lose. I mean, he's a Newport guy. I'm a Cardiff boy. He's from Newport. I know what Newport boys are like. They are rough. And believe me, they do not take losing lightly.
Well, I guess that's definitely gonna stick with him. But I think JC Wolfe also wants Mason to prove a point tonight, as, you know, I think from the showing of Draven, last week, I definitely think I think JC Wolfe wants Mason to represent that monstrous type of guy that he has. You know, the freak show has a monster, well, I got a monster of my own.
It definitely, that's what he's gonna need. He's gonna need those powerhouses, but here we go, both men in the ring. As it's overhead, belly to belly, Mason Wolfe not wasting any time there showing off that strength.
And JC Wolfe looking pretty pleased on the outside of the ring right now. Definitely liking the start to this. Whoa! Here we go, Steele showing off some of that strength of his own. Oh, and stomping down on Mason. Mason Wolfe's gonna look trying to find something right now. But what are we seeing? A power slam! Okay, what a move right there.
This is the strength that Blake Steele does have. You know, he's not intimidated by a big man like somebody like Mason Wolfe. I'm seeing Blake Steele now in control this one. JC Wolfe only just started the match, and JC Wolfe already looks pissed off.
Oh, well, and looks like he went for a lariat. Mason, I guess, see it in the pistosity. Oh, just dropping him. Steele on the back of his knee.
And he's going to use that power. The thing is, these guys, very similar in height, very similar in size. So there's going to be nobody who's going to have that advantage. So this is going to be a really close match as we see Mason using some of that strength, just draping with a slingshot, suplex with one arm there.
Damn, you know, here's the thing, like, I like this back and forth, right now, kind of a bear hug, just lifting him up. Is Steele gonna have to tap out? Nope, he's finding a way, elbowing him off, oh, and a clap to the ears, discombobulating your opponent. Oh, but he trips him onto the ropes right there.
There's the agility you were talking about, they just sliding through over the top of his opponent with that beautiful, almost like, sent on there in the back. Oh! Knocked him out!
Jesus Christ. Oh! Oh my god, just like with that. Wait, was that an STO? I can't quite recall what that is at the moment, but there we go.
I think it was a flatliner, as they call it, a flatliner. This is not enough to keep his opponent down, and now Blake Steele showing off some strength with a little scythe and driving Mason. This is just a power off.
Here's the thing, man. I kind of think there's a little bit of a point to prove on both ends. JC Wolfe probably wanting to prove a point to Freak Show, whereas Isabelle, I think she kind of wants to prove a point to JC and Mercedes. Probably that, you know, okay, you have the title for now, but V12, we're to come for you guys.
Definitely want that to, as you see now. Blake still using that strength, but no, it's reversed, and Mason just drops in face-to-face with the gold buster there. This is what I mean about agility.
What's going on? He's not gonna do what I think he's gonna do. Whoa! Okay! I'm liking that, right? And again, over the head of Mason Wolfe.
That is what I mean. This guy has scare, and then there's he does two of those big overhands and just nets his opponent straight in the face. Mason Wolfe is look. Oh, we've seen him do this before. Check this out.
Oh my goodness! Just springboarding elbow drop. Is that going to be it? One, two. Oh no! So close. Is he gonna have to? He's gonna have to pull out something big, and it looks like that's just what he has in mind. Something big. Is he gonna be able to hit it and lift him up?
Oh, I love this move, and the fireman's carry power bomb, and straight up on the ropes, rolling through on that pin. He gets the pin. Mason Wolfe proving why he is the powerhouse he was. What a match! A quick win there for Mason Wolfe as well.
Yeah, definitely. Hey, Draven. Hey, if Freak Show wanted to prove a point with Draven, I think JC Wolfe just proved a point with Mason Wolfe right now. Let's see if that'll have a lasting impression on the Freak Show.
I just had a crazy idea.
What? What would that be? What would that be?
I just had a crazy idea. So, closing up, look, we have got our pay-per-view coming up. We've got pay-per-view locked down. Once we break out, but there's a video at the end of the show to explain why have you changed to lockdown. Can you imagine Mason Wolfe,
here is your winner,
Draven, locked in a steel cage?
Oh goodness, that would be, oh god, I fear for the safety of everybody in JCPW. Anyone who could probably be in that, everyone who would be in the arena, I'd have a lot of fear of what could possibly happen. That would probably be an incredible match, though.
Do you know what? I am going to look into that one, because I think I'm going to create a little bit of a Monsters Raw match. I'll explain the rules to you. I'll look into the logistics, and I'll make a little video as to what this is going to be. Because I've got an idea in my head. It's probably a stupid idea, and somebody will definitely get injured. But we are going to go with that. But ladies and gentlemen, we are going to take another short commercial break. We'll be right back, right after this.
Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Think and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. Yeah. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6.
Yes, sir.
Think and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. It's time for you to get into the character. You hit to lose, or hit to win, I'm only asking you. Either you beat them or you beat them like an amateur. Either you drive or you get driven like a passenger. The fight's around the corner, so pick the one you want to. Represent your way, go head to head with your opponent. Feel it in the air, tension is electric. The glory's imminent, this is something epic. Least for one of you, so what you gonna do? When your enemy is standing right in front of you, are you gonna lose, or are you gonna prove to everyone that never thought you win that you could? Cause everything is in your hands, you control it. And everything that is the past, it is over. This is now, this is everything that is. So you better make the right pick. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1. Select the one to fight with. Get it on. 10-9-8-7-6. Pick and choose the right one. Get it on. 5-4-3-2-1.
Welcome back, everybody, to JCPW, and we have come to our final match of the evening. It is the main event. We've seen a great show so far. We've seen the introduction of the new title. You just saw great debut matches, and also you are now here to the main event. Jason, we're looking forward to this main event because we will see the women's champion in action.
Yes, Mercedes, you know, after cashing in her briefcase, and now she's going against a pretty impressive woman so far. You know, she had one recent loss, but that doesn't seem to be fazing her too much. Alina Valentina.
Definitely the mother of Russia, the Russian queen, as she likes to call herself. A superstar who has generally come into her own here in JCPW. I mean, she came, she requested to join the show, and she turned out, you know, quite bland, quite a very generic moveset. But we've got, although this is all about competition here, you know, we are here to help superstars develop as well. And I've got to be honest, you know, if we had a training facility or like an NXT style thing or Tough Enough, this would be one of our people we brought up, because she's just evolved into a superstar. She's no longer just a fighter, she's a superstar. I mean, look, the attitudes.
Hey, the pride in the country, you know, the movesets, you know, she brings a lot that's great to the show, you know, and I can't lie about that. The minute I was first introduced to her, I was like, okay, this is something I can vibe with.
Here we go, everybody's favorite entrance video. Here we go, boys, close your doors. And there she is, the JCPW. Look, JC Wolfe is making his presence known tonight. It's the second time he's been out.
Oh, JC Wolfe taking pride in his, in his teammates, taking pride in his stable, taking pride in his champions. You know, it's definitely something you want to see. And, you know, Mercedes, you know, ever since cashing in that briefcase, she definitely felt some type of pride in her accomplishments, you know, being the JCPW Women's Champion more than once. That's definitely an accomplishment. What a shine.
Is the third ever two-time JCPW Women's Champion. Which just shows, you know, all the talk that she does get, all the things people say about her. She's a superstar who knows what she's doing in the ring. As the bell rings and we go straight into it, and Mercedes just tossing an opponent away. Like, disrespect there, maybe.
And once again and again into the corner. And oh, now she's just playing around with her. And whoop! Oh, okay, backbreaker into the head, like a lariat to the back of the head. Jesus Christ, and Mercedes is just taunting away today.
Mercedes is going to be confident. Has her up for the widow's peak there. Ooh, the pin. Oh, no way, Mercedes. Come on, you got to give some respect.
It's like, oh, and a kick to the back. Alina's got to figure out something right now. This is not the way she wants to start out this match. Especially with the women's champion. Come on, Alina. You got to put something in there. Oh, tilt the world. Sidewalk slam. The amount of strength for Mercedes to pull off something like that. And calling Alina up to her feet.
See, this is, there's no denying that Mercedes is a great superstar, beautiful drop kick off that middle rope there. She's a great superstar, but there's just something about arrogance that can cost you. But look at Alina!
Whoa, wrestling right now. That's some wrestling maneuvers right there. Right now, it seems as though Mercedes is doubling back, but that arm lock is pretty in tight. Oh, but Mercedes. Oh. It's a shot to the head.
Beautiful Kimura lock there. Beautiful Alina used that move. But this face, the X Factor there, or the face Bella Buster, whatever you want to call it. I think Mercedes realizing that Alina's not messing around, but there we go. Alina playing a little bit of possum there. And that seems Alina is now in control.
Oh, dropping her down, that kind of wrestling style. Here's the thing, Alina is a straight up wrestler / submission expert. She definitely can take, I think she can definitely take Mercedes in the technical, oh god, just hitting that midsection multiple times, making Mercedes drop down to her feet.
Definitely. Alina is, you know, she's trained in Sambo, which is a Russian style of wrestling, and she has spent some time MMA training as well, but look at this spinning Falcon Arrow there. I think Mercedes now realizes that Alina is not met. Just as they say that, she gets on the middle and starts taunting again.
And Mercedes, she just can't help herself. She just can't help herself. Hopefully that won't cost her. Oh, suplex. Suplex City a little bit.
She's just looking. You reckon she is just looking past Alina? I think that's the, there seems an attitude there that shows, you know, who's Alina Valentina. As you see, a little hip toss there and then rolls to the outside.
Is the arrogance from Alina? Isn't it? Definitely arrogance, but who knows? Maybe that's going to cost her one of these days. Maybe one of these days she's going to, but wait, as I say that, powerbomb. What an excellent maneuver right there. What a way to reverse a kick like that. And here we go. Now she's dropping her up, pulling her up to her feet. And what's it called? Oh, the wrestling game herself. A little bit of a leg lock. Dropping some elbows in the mix.
Dropping the elbows to the top of the head there. And we know Mercedes likes to hit that beautiful moonsault DDT. Looks like she's... Are we going to see that moonsault DDT from Mercedes? Alina getting to her feet. Moonsault. Oh! Alina's ready for it.
Dropping face first onto the mat. That's not going to feel good. Right now, she doesn't even know where she is. And Gold taking a kick to the leg. And what's it?
Drapes
it. Just draped the ropes. Oh! God, those vicious knees. Oh!
And that is the striking excellence that is Alina Valentina. Some devastating striking, just straight knees to the top of the face there. And on the outside with another wrestling takedown there. I think Mercedes is going for a clothesline maybe, but she was a duck and a... Oh, Mercedes! I think Mercedes is pissed.
Mercedes, I think she's had enough of Alina just staying in this. I think she's kind of ready to end this, wrap this up, but definitely can't. I don't think you can do that from the outside. Oh, what the? Was not expecting that. Arm trap, spine buster onto the outside. She has put women away with that. Got to get her back in the ring, though.
It's going to weaken the arm for that beautiful anaconda vice that she started using recently. Really going to work the arm. Mercedes is just getting caught with strikes, but reversal. Oh, this is the athleticism. Standing moonsault there.
Could have gone into the pin with that one, but you know, I guess she thought, if I put her down, I want to put her down.
Everyone's with that. She throws it into the timber. Trash talking. Oh, woo! As the crowd would go. If this crowd was live, I see another standing moonsault. Mercedes is now kind of maybe taking us a little bit serious.
Yeah, I definitely think Mercedes is taking this seriously. Oh, but Alina getting back up to her feet, showing that she's taking this just as serious. Alina, I mean, this is not an every moment type thing that Alina probably could have expected, you know? A chop and a DDT. Christ. Alina definitely wants this out here with something to prove. She's facing off with the women's champ.
Faking out the shot there. And I see now, Mercedes now maybe thinking, okay, now it's time to get this match sorted. And there is Hazard up for that beautiful Aerie crash neckbreaker. She's won matches with that one.
I don't think she's done. I don't think she's done. She's calling her to her feet, and I think we all know what she's gonna go for.
Oh, that beautiful running, flying knee strike.
Is that gonna be... she's taunting. Taunting, just go for the pin. Oh my goodness, she's not going for the pin. She's taunting, she's taking her time.
Alina hasn't moved, though. Alina hasn't moved. There's one, there's two, and there is three. That knee strike definitely knocked out Alina. I think that was square under the chin there as you go through the replays. Impressive victory, but so many flaws in that one. I mean, I don't know, Jason. What?
I definitely think that Mercedes could have had many opportunities to close this match much earlier, but she was so interested in taunting, so interested in, you know, talking about herself, making herself the
big person here. I definitely think, had she continued any longer, this could have been Alina's.
I think that's essentially those talks, but there you go, your winner of the match is Mercedes. Again, an impressive victory for Mercedes there. Oh no. You just see that on screen.
What's going on?
Oh, the lights, ladies and gentlemen, the lights have gone. Oh, I know what's coming. Please.
No. What's this? Who's this person?
Well, there's Fink, look up, and there's the ringleader. What the hell was that?
My goodness! She just took out the women's champion!
Oh, she's not done there. One move took out the women's champion. What is...
Oh my god!
Oh, who the hell? Finkel Goldman. Clearly a member of the Freak Show. You see Finkel Goldman on the outside there.
Ladies, what did we just witness?
Exactly. Not the way we wanted to end the show. I mean, the women's champion has been laid out by whoever that was. I mean, that was an impressive move. I won't deny that. That stunner off the top rope, but this is going too far. This is, when will the Freak Show be done? I don't know.
We got to establish order, man. We got to establish order here.
We have, ladies and gentlemen, but we got to go to hello everybody, and welcome to this very quick JCPW update. Hope you did enjoy the show, but want to do this little update at the end of the show just to let you know of a quick announcement with regards to some upcoming show, an upcoming pay-per-view that will be happening for us very, very soon. For those who have followed the show, we did have our breakout pay-per-view planned very, very soon. I think it was planned last week or the end of this week. Obviously, due to what is going on in the world right now, we've been unable to actually do that one. So, we are going to postpone our Day of Vengeance pay-per-view, and we are going to change our breakout pay-per-view into something a little bit different, maybe just to give it a little bit of entertainment to all those who are currently stuck inside due to the measures and the whole Steve Corino that is going on. So the pay-per-view is now having a name change, and we have a venue change as well. So it's no longer Breakout. We are now going to be calling the episode, the pay-per-view will now be called, as you can see on the screen, will now be called Lockdown. And as we know, imagine we all currently are on a lockdown ourselves. So we are going to change it up. So we are going to be having Lockdown. It will be in the Cardiff City Stadium, obviously in Cardiff, in my hometown. And we will be bringing you some great matches and great shows. We will bring the same shows. We'll bring you the Hardcore Heaven match, which we've had for the last 2 years. And there will be some other matches in as well. But as we do know, the whole thing with Lockdown is everything is within the steel cage, or a steel cage of some sort. Oh, excuse me. So yeah, that is what is going on. We still got the great matches, as it is saying, all will be inside those steel cages. And this show now will be coming up at the end of the month. So around the 30th of April, the 1st of May, we'll try and get out around that weekend. So I'll see if you've got something to watch as we are going into the final few weeks of this lockdown, especially in the UK. We are going into those final weeks, but fingers crossed, everything will come through. So, from myself here in JCPW, don't forget to keep an eye on that one. We'll give you an announcement of matches as well. But that's what's going to be happening at the end of the month. But from myself here at JCPW, we hope you are staying safe, hope you're staying home, and we hope you are keeping yourselves sane and enjoying stuff and still supporting all the great companies, all the great people that are still putting out great content, including ourselves. But from myself and the JCPW team, we will see you all on the next episode. Have a great day, and as I did say, stay safe, guys. We'll see you all soon.